In this class, we'll continue with the same question, but we'll try to find it out the input impedance seen by the transmitter. It is the same question what we have solved in the previous video, but the only thing is, now I have to find it out what would be the input impedance if I look from here. So I have to find the Zin, right? What we know about the Zin? What is Zin? Zin is nothing but input impedance is given by Z0 ZL plus JZ0 tan beta L Z0 plus JZL tan beta L. And this is for a lossless transmission line, right? And it is being already given that it's a lossless transmission line, right? Okay. So Z0, yes, Z0 is given to me, which comes out to be 50. ZL is also given to, which comes out to be a complex quantity. The only thing is, I have to conclude what is a beta L, right? So once I conclude the beta L part, this question is completed. Okay. Let's see that what will be a beta L part. Now, what is the length? Length is also given to us, right? It is 4 meter. The only thing is, I have to find what is the beta, right? So once the beta, I am able to find it out, this question has nothing left, right? Okay. Let's see that how I can find the beta. What I know is Vp or the phase velocity is given by omega by beta. Omega, I can easily find it out, right? Because omega is being given to me, right? Or I can say the frequency is given to me, which comes out to be 2 pi f by beta, right? Which comes out to be, it comes out to be 500 megahertz. Now, the another thing is, what would be the phase velocity, right, Vp? See, if it is an airfield, right, if it is an airfield, we can say that the velocity will be equal to the velocity of light. But it is not traveling in airfield, it is traveling in some Teflon field, right, which has some permittivity, right. So, we cannot say that Vp will be equal to C. So, we have to find it out what is Vp. How we can find Vp? It's very easy. Vp is also equal to 1 by mu epsilon, right. So, if I solve this, it would be nothing but 1 by root over mu naught epsilon naught mu r epsilon r, right. So, if I conclude on this, I am going to consider mu r as 1, because there is nothing being told about the magnetic property. So, it would be nothing but 1 by root over mu naught epsilon naught, and I am going to put like this epsilon r. 1 by root over mu naught epsilon naught is nothing but equal to C. So, this comes out to be C divided by root over epsilon r, and this will be what is your Vp. Epsilon r is given to us, right? It is 2.1. So, once we have find epsilon r, we have to just substitute here. So, this comes out to be, so the Vp would be 2 pi, f is nothing but 500 megahertz, 500 into 10 to the power 6 divided by beta, or it is nothing but I have to find beta now, right? I have to find actually beta. So, what I am going to do is, we are going to switch here, beta here, I am going to substitute Vp here, right? And beta is equal to 2 pi into 500 into 10 to the power 6 divided by Vp, which comes out to be C, which comes out to be 3 into 10 to the power 8 divided by root over epsilon r, which comes out to be how much? 2.1. Right? If you solve this in your calculator, you can get beta as 15.18 radians per second. So, this will be what will be the value of beta. Once you got the beta, there is nothing left in the question, right? Because length L is 4 meter, beta is 15.18, you will easily get the tan, right? So, you have to just put the values in your calculator and you can easily find what is the input impedance. So, input impedance in this problem, this comes out to be, if you solve in your calculator, this comes out to be 14.66, this will be nothing but your real part, minus J 24.17. So this will be the input impedance in this problem. So the only important thing was finding the beta in this question, right? Once we are able to find it out beta, there is nothing left in finding the input impedance. So we have concluded how, what would be the input impedance in this case. In the next videos, we will see one more set of this, which will be nothing but one more question on this and how to proceed on that.